Spark Police today released body camera footage from March 29, 2024, where a gunman shot multiple officers in three separate ambushes. At 1:40 p.m., SPD initiated a traffic stop on a Ford Expedition with no license plates. As the officer approached the vehicle, the driver pulled out a gun and fired at the officer, striking him multiple times before the officer returned fire. The suspect took off before crashing at the intersection, disabling his vehicle. The suspect then entered a residence with a gun, where he was cut by the resident using a knife before he fled out the back. The suspect then entered another home, taking a woman hostage, and made her drive out of the search area while he hid in the back of her car. As the vehicle was trying to leave, officers told the woman to shelter in place and to park back in the garage. A deputy spotted the hostage lying on the floor in the doorway. As the deputy identified himself as police, the suspect opened fire on law enforcement, striking a deputy and officer before officers returned fire and dragged the victim to safety. The suspect then fled out the back of the house and into another home before exiting out the back and hiding in a shed for around 15 minutes before re-entering the home and hiding in the garage. SWAT operators then entered the garage where the suspect again opened fire on officers, striking the officers' guns. The officers returned fire, striking the suspect.
Shots fired! It's going westbound, eastbound! Upshot. It's just 10:50. This way, turn around. Behind you. Where'd he go? Looks like he jumped the fence at. BMA, jean jacket. I think I need medics, med personnel.
What's the address for emergency?
Yeah. Is it ever the gunman or? Is it ever with a gun in our house?
There's a guy in your house with a gun?
He ran out of backyard.
He was on the backyard and came inside.
Where is he?
I think he went to the other house.
Wait, it's okay. Which way? Do you went this way?
In the backyard, and then I think he jumped the fence, but I don't know where.
Sparks, police!
Police department!
Hey, just cover me just in case the guy might be in there.
Police department, show me your hands! Show me your hands!
Sparks, police!
Put your hands up!
Stop! That doesn't look like anyone's in there. All right, so we have a critical incident that's going on. It's kind of dangerous right now. Did anyone jump inside your yard or backyard?
No.
Where are you headed to?
To the store.
Okay. What I need you to do, can you go inside your house and shelter in place?
Okay.
Let's get this family out of here. And we need them for detectives. So they get more information.
Yeah.
Well, please.
Hey, there's an older WFA in this house. She's the one I talked to.
Did they come back inside?
Yeah.
Hello, police.
Get up! Get up! Hey, stand up. Are you hurt?
No.
Get her up!
I got her. Here, I got one hand, you get the other. Let's go. Let's get behind the car. Stay right here, man.
Bro, get the fuck out of there.
Stay right there.
Yeah.
Get her out!
I don't know, he's in back away from
me.
He's shooting deep. He's shooting at us deep.
What's the address of the emergency? And what's the phone number that you're calling me from? Okay, and tell me exactly what happened.
We had broken in my house and barricaded my bedroom. The police had got the street locked off. He's got to break down the front door and come in.
Okay. He's barricaded in the bathroom?
No, I'm in the bathroom. He's on my side.
Does he know you're in there?
I don't know, maybe.
What's your name?
I'm scared to death.
Stay right there, watch. Yeah, go right there.
We got blood on the fridge here.
The suspect was later identified as 34-year-old Reno resident Anthony Wade. The investigation revealed that Wade was in possession of a loaded black 40-caliber semi-automatic firearm with a 22-round capacity extended magazine at the time of the incident.